It's too loud, you take it because you're so mad. It's time for salat, you take the phone, you shut it off. Sometimes you throw it somewhere, even when it turns on, it's on the azan, you're not going to respond again. Why? Because you waited for the reality shows before. Wallahi, you waited for the reality shows before. Allah is already specially waiting for you. Especially waiting for you. You will never have ever seen the reality of the salats that you pray until when you and I meet on ourselves in the grave. May Allah the Almighty guide and protect us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله قيوم السماوات والأرض وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل together let's be our Almighty and let's be beautiful to our Almighty and let's know the purpose of our creation and whatsoever that we're doing we should know that Wallahi let's do it with a clean heart and we should do it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our ibadahs. May Allah the Almighty accept our ibadahs. Whatsoever that we're doing that's gonna lead us astray. May Allah the Almighty guide and protect us. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Wallahi as-salat is the best topic in our life. The best topic in our life is the topic of what as-salat. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, we cannot offer our salat the way that we wait or the way that you and I, we want to pray. Wallahi, you can pray as you want. You are in good health, nothing happens to you because you see people sitting on the chair. You say, I want to wake my back a little bit. You grab a chair, you also sit down, you pray. Your salat will not be accepted. Your salat will not be accepted. Even those that are using the church, there are conditions that they have to fall under that conditions. If they don't fall under that conditions, there is so many ways. Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you cannot stand to pray with some conditions, you should sit down. If you can't sit down to pray, he said, you should lie down and pray. You should lie down and pray. And look at what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, we cannot pray the way we want, but rather learn from our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So as Muslims, you should know what makes your salat valid and what void your salat. What makes your salat invalid? And there are what? 3 things without it, Wallahi, brother in Islam, forget about your salat. There are 3 conditions, you don't fulfill these conditions in your salat, Wallahi, pray until the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah the Almighty will reject all your salat. Allah the Almighty, He will reject all your salat, subhanAllah. Imagine you work for 1,000 hours and they say each hour they're going to pay you $1,000 and after you finish all these 1,000 hours, they say no, we're not going to pay you nothing. I think you're going to take that person to the school hall. So imagine you pray all these years without you fulfilling these 3 conditions, you come to Yawm al-Qiyamah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling the people of as-salat, you come in Allah the Almighty, He says, no, you stand aside. Because your salat wasn't accepted. Why? Because you didn't fulfill the three things that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says. One is what? Ash-shurut as-salat. The second aspect is what? Arkan as-salat. And then the wajibat as-salat. These 3 things, without these 3 things, Wallahi, your salat will never and ever be looked at from the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nor even accepted. And then when we break it down, we have what? We have 6 shurut as-salat, which is the requirement. If you don't have it, Wallahi, pray, as I said, until the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, Allah the Almighty will reject all your salat. And then we have 12 arkan as-salat, and then we have 7 wajibat. We have 7 wajibat, we have what? 6 shurut, and then we have 12 arkan salah. These are things that you have to take it upon yourself. Go and read about it. But the first shurut to salah is what? At-tahara. At-tahara is the first shurut. The shurut to salah. You can't pray without you making at-tahara. You have to go and what? Purify. Meaning at-tahara to mean al-adasa. Making wudu is the first point. You can say no. You know, in Salat, I can pray without even wudu. You go pray. Where do you think your Salat is going to go? Your Salat is not going to go anywhere. As you're making the Tahara, you should know how you should make your Tahara. Don't go and stand between you, pee, and then all your clothes. You have what? You have the urine. You come out, you didn't use no water to clean it, you make your wudu, you come and pray. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, your salat will not be accepted. And under the what? Under the conditions of what? The shurutu salat, al-tahara is the most important thing. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said at a time that when you make al-tahara, you go and make your wudu. You come into prayer, Allah the Almighty, he sends so beautiful two angels. One is at your right side, and the other one is at your what? Left side. And they keep spraying your body with a very beautiful lavender that comes from heaven. Because you come in to stand before Allah, you come in to stand, or you come in to be the guest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. God has made space for others too. Inshallah. You're going to become the what? You're going to become the guest of what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah the Almighty, or the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he says, Ash-shurutu salat, we have six. The first one is what? At-tahara. You making what? At-tahara to min al-hadasa. Or you to make wudu. And the second one is what? At-tahara to min al-what? Najasa. Purification from what? A filthy things. A filthy things meaning, if you know something touch your clothes, make sure you clean it. If you know it's going to make your salat void, try to clean it before you even go. You make wudu and come and stand before Allah. If you have to clean it, then you should know that the masjid that we pray needs to be clean. If you come to the masjid, you see the masjid is not clean, wallahi, you can ask, please, where is the vacuum? Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was explaining this to the Sahaba, he said, whosoever take one particle of his sand, if you see one drop of a particle of a sand in the masjid, you take it out. You pick it out for you to go and throw it out. At the time that you're going to go now, pick it out. Each step that you take, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah the Almighty will command a special angel. They're going to spread their wings and then you're going to be working on that. And each step you get 10 more. Allah Akbar. One particle. Imagine, look at how big is the masjid. You come, you vacuum the masjid. You don't vacuum when somebody is vacuuming, you keep talking. You don't vacuum, you vacuum when people are praying. When he left it, you're not gonna do it. Why do you have to talk? Why do you have to talk? You keep talking, the imam doesn't even know how to read. When they ask you to read, wallah, you can read. The imam doesn't know how to perform salat. When they ask you, you can even lead the salat. That you are the one who go talking, before you realize, wallahi, al-mawtu ba'dun wa al-qawru sawtun al-amal. Before you realize, wallahi, you find yourself in the grave. When you find yourself in the grave, it's too late. It's too late. So that is the second what? The second part of what? At-tahara to min al-najasa. Purification from what? Filthy things. Meaning, the place, the clothes, needs to be clean. The place you're going to pray, it should be clean. And then the clothes that you wear should also be clean. What of we the youth? Sometimes I know I wear, my length is 42 or 43. I go and buy length 12. And then the pants will be hanging. It's just be hanging. You come into prayer, you can't even go on ruku properly. Because why? When you go down, people, the one behind you, he will see your back. Who you showing your back to? You showing your back to Allah? Or you trying to make the one behind you his salat, his mind to get out of the salat? What is your mind? All these conditions is something that we need to pay attention to. It's something that needs to be fulfilled when you pray. May Allah the Almighty guide and protect us. And then from filthy things and place, and then the third part is what? Al-waqt, time. Time is very, very important when it comes to what? When it comes to salat. Because there is time for each prayer. And the fourth one is what? It's the time of qibla. But it's the time of qibla. Because we know this is the Qibla. We have to face this way. Imagine if I say Istanbul Sufufakum and then I begin to face this way to pray, will you follow me? You might think this guy is a lunatic. This guy, there's something wrong with his wife praying. You can say, no, I'm from the south. So I'm going to face what? The south to pray. But I'm from the north, so I'm going to face the north to pray. No. If you do that, your select, my brother, my sister, your select will not be even looked at by Allah the Almighty. Not even put it on your mizan. So if you are fond of doing that, your life, try to fix it. Try to fix it for your salat to be accepted. Other than that, to apply you and I, we're going to go to Yawm al-Qiyamah and the Arafah of Yawm al-Qiyamah. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَتَعَتْنَاهُ أَبَاهُ مَنْفُورًا. Everything will already be. We go to Yawm al-Qiyamah and the Arafah of Yawm al-Qiyamah with 0% of what point. May Allah the Almighty guide and protect us. That's Al-Waqt. Time. What is the plan of Qibla? And the fifth one is what? Sutrat al-Awra. Sutrat al-Awra, very, very important. I didn't mention of that earlier on. Sutrat al-Awra, wallahi, when you go to pray, because during the lifetime of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a little kid Allah has blessed him with knowledge of Al-Quran. So sometimes the people in the community, they let him go lead salat. But whenever he go for ruku or sujood, the people behind him, not the men, even the women, they see his what? They see his aura. And then they pleaded and they said, please, can you please find something to cover his aura? Because even we, the ladies at the back, we see his aura. Which means, sutrat al-awra, you should know the clothes. The type of clothes you want to wear. And then the ladies, whenever it comes to a sutrat al-awra, don't put anything which is so tight. Which is so tight to the extent whatever that you have under, it's showing the shape of whatever that you have, under. Allah the Almighty says, the angels will not even look at you, not even accept your salam. Subhanallah. Is this not the reality of what is happening? Not even the ladies, sometimes we the men too. We do that, we go buy some skinny pants. Wallahi, you can't even go on what? Ruku properly. You not even go on sujood. That is why when you pray like a chicken. Within 2-3 minutes, 2 seconds, 5 seconds, you turn with your salat. Wallahi, when you finish, Allah the Almighty will tell the angel, for all these prayers, don't even look at him. Just throw it back to him. Because he what? He didn't do the right thing. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tonight and protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring back the glory of Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, a salat is very important in our life. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatsoever salat that we're doing, Ya Allah, we pray to you, put in our mizan of salat. Whatever mistakes we make, Ya Allah, we still learn. We still learn, Ya Allah, forgive us. We pray to Allah the Almighty, among us are those people who are sick. May Allah give them shifa, Allah ibadah wa sakama. May Allah give them shifa, Allah ibadah wa sakama. We continue to say, Wallahi, whatever that we say in this khutbah, that is indeed right way from Allah and His Messenger. May Allah shall have blessed with the future of all of us. Whatever that we say, either it's misinterpretation or it's a slip of tongue. Wallahi, this the fault is from us. We are students seeking knowledge, may Allah forgive us. Among us are those who are facing challenges with the child. With the family, with the immigration. Allah the Almighty, you are the solver of all problems, may Allah solve our problems. May Allah solve our problems. Since the creation of Adam up to this time, those who die, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make their soul rest in perfect peace. When also our time comes for us to depart from this world, may our last kalma be the kalma la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اعداءك اعداء الدين وانصر عبادك الجاهلين في كل مكان اللهم فرج عن المحرومين ونف سلام المكروهين واقل الدين على المدينين واشفع مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين اللهم حرم الحق حق وارزقنا اجتنابه وحرم الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم لك الحمد كله اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك اللهم اللهم انت الغفار ونحن الغفور ولا يغفر الغفور الا الغفار فارحمنا يا غفار اللهم انت الرحمن ونحن الرحيم ولا يرحم الرحيم الا الرحمن فارحمنا يا رحمن فارحمنا يا رحمن اللهم انت الستار ونحن المستور ولا يستر المستور الا الستار فاسترنا يا ستار واسترنا يا ستار اللهم ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد كما صليت ورحمت وبارك على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اقوم الى صلاتكم ورحمه الله.